the theory of reintegrative therapy is that essentially healthy psychosexual development leads to sexual maturity. And a sexual mature person, their feelings and their desires are in line with their biological reality. Young boys have an additional developmental task that young girls do not have at around age 2 or so, as gender sexual identity is becoming more clear for a child. I'm a boy, you're a girl. They have to shift from primary attachment to mom to primary attachment with same-sex father figure, which is ideally dad. We want to explore what possible factors that we would call relational traumas, either the presence of bad things that happened to you or the absence of good, important things that should have happened to you that didn't happen, may have contributed to disruption or interruption of the normal sexual developmental process. It was both pleasurable and traumatic. And so that, yes, as you can imagine, creates tremendous confusion for the molestation victim.
The recent Vatican document, Fiducia Supplicans, has created tremendous controversy and generated wide-ranging commentary and discussion. As a defender of traditional Christian sexual morality, the Ruth Institute is committed to offering straightforward answers to the many issues this document raises. We at the Ruth Institute are particularly concerned about a group of people that has barely been mentioned in all the discussion. I'm referring to the people who experience persistent same-sex attraction and who strive to live according to the ancient teachings of the Christian faith. We fear that this latest document may demoralize these already marginalized and socially invisible people. The Ruth Institute strives to accompany and encourage those who are journeying away from an LGBT identity.